Hey guys, welcome back to Food and Travel with Festive Forever. I'm Tejasvi and right now we are in Andheri. Today we are going to visit Foo Andheri, which has recently opened and has couple of outlets in Mumbai. This restaurant is quite famous for its Asian food and let me tell you that this place is quite huge and pretty. So let's go inside and enjoy some delicious food. Let's go. So guys, as you have already seen that the place is pretty and huge. There are two types of sitting. One is indoor and the other is outdoor. Outdoors, it was very hot. That's why we decided to sit inside. Though there were coolers, if you're comfortable, then you can sit outside. If you're not, then you can sit inside. So let's eat some Asian food. First thing that we have is called jalapeno snapper dumplings. So let's open it. They have somewhere tried to recreate jalapeno, which is like a form of chili and little bit spicy. So in portion size, there are three dumplings. Let's go ahead and just lift one. Now it's time to eat this. I'm considering that since they have said jalapeno, it's going to be spicy. Also, this includes snapper fish. I think if you're aware of red snapper. So let's go ahead and just try this. I'm just gonna add some chili to it. You can say a little bit of chili oil. Because I don't think so, it's that spicy. I feel that the dish tastes better with chili oil, and as we all know that the dumplings are steamed, so the fish has to be steamed. So basically it's steamed fish dumplings. Flavors are mild and also it's less on salt, which is kind of, you know, a plus point, because when you add chili oil or chili sauce, it tastes even better. While going through their menu, I also discovered that there are different types of dumplings, like in different shape and sizes. So if you like them, you can just order them because they look very pretty. Also, one more thing, in case you don't want three and you want bigger portion, then I think they kind of increase it by one. Like if you are two people, then you can order four. Now let me enjoy my dumplings and I'm gonna see you for my next starter. It's time to enjoy my second starter. So for second starter, I have again called for something which is made from snapper. So here we have snapper crisp. Basically, it's going to be very crispy. That's what I have been told. So let's go ahead and try it. I actually wanted to try this first because, you know, eventually it will just become soggy. So you have to try this very fresh and just when it arrives on your table. So I'm gonna try it. So it has this very sweet and spicy taste, like how you eat soya sauce and chili, soya sauce, chili sauce and some tomato ketchup or chili sweet sauce. So vaisa taste hai. They have also very crispy, similar to sweet chili chicken. But I do believe that this dish is better than the dumplings, probably because dumplings were somewhere bland and this is more flavorful and I enjoy a lot of flavors, so maybe that's why. But then the dish is nice. It got this sweet and spicy taste along with some chilies, like red chili, spring onion, kind of tasty. Moving on, the third starter that we have is this. It's called daikin cakes. It's a Japanese radish which is fried and then it's served in the form of cake with burnt garlic and some onions. So let's go ahead and take one. Let's just eat it like that and then we'll see, do we need any sauces or anything. It has a very, very strong flavor of garlic and I love burnt garlic, so I'm already loving it. I have a very strong feeling that they have boiled the radish, mashed it, rolled it like a cake and then fried it. Uske baad I think usme thoda bahut burnt garlic and onions they must have added and served it. So that's my basic concept, or I feel that's how it's been made. If you want to add more taste and flavor, then you can of course go ahead and add chili oil. I don't think so you need it. I feel that I can just enjoy this thing just like that. It's time for our main course, and for main course we have blue butter Japanese fried rice along with asparagus chili oil. Basically they have made a curry. Now let's go ahead and serve ourselves. I must say that this blue butter Japanese fried rice looks absolutely beautiful. Look at the color. Amazing. Gravy on the top. Ideally with blue butter rice you're supposed to have coconut curry, but then I just called for chili oil curry. Let's just mix it. So in case if you want, you can go ahead and try some coconut curry, which goes best with blue butter rice. Yummy. This chili oil gravy is so spicy, of course, because they have added chili oil. Let's just taste this butter rice. I love this blue color. It's very buttery. I actually think they were right. This rice would go better with coconut curry, but it's not tasting bad. If you don't like coconut curry, that is yellow coconut curry, then you can go ahead and try the chili oil gravy. All right, it's time to have our dessert, and for dessert we have sesame cheese cake along with some ice cream. It has this marble texture which looks absolutely pretty and stunning. So let's go ahead and dig into this yummy delicious marble cheese cake. I'm gonna take a good amount of ice cream. Yummy. I really like how they have made the combination of butter biscuit along with some cheesecake. Very moist, very tasty. And sesame seeds are not that dominant, or you can say ki sesame seeds ka utna taste nahi hai ya fir utna strong flavor nahi hai, but then the cheesecake is absolutely delicious. It's moist, it's creamy. Love the quality, enjoying it. Vanilla ice cream ke saath to bahut hi tasty lag raha hai. Festive meter time, the place is quite decent and pretty. As you can see that the place is huge, it's big, and there are like different sitting for different set of people. If you're two, if you're three, if you're four, they have all kinds of sitting. Indoor sitting is more like, you know, having some dim light and with good music, cocktails and just, you know, good service. And when it comes to outdoor sitting, it's more like sunny, little hot, and you know, chilling kind of a thing. Also, if you're coming on Sunday, they have a brunch menu which is for 1400 plus taxes, with alcohol, without alcohol, there are different. If you're having with alcohol, then it is 2300 plus taxes. Food is decent, everything is like, it's kind of a decent place. So on the basis of my experience, I'm gonna rate this place 8.5 out of 10 on my festive meter. This rating is based on ambiance, food, pricing, service and presentation. So guys, I hope you love this vlog. Do consider subscribing my channel. It helps my channel to grow. Also, if you have any query regarding the present vlog or any suggestion regarding my future vlogs, please do leave it in the comment section below. I will definitely get back to you, or I'll definitely make that improvement in my vlogs. So guys, I'm gonna end my vlog over here. See you in my next vlog. Till then, live life festive style. Bye bye.